gather them at dawn.
You will take me back and die at my hands.
Though it feels a little scratchy. Maybe some steeped borage and chamomile will do the trick.
Delilah done to my throne? If I change the number of corrupt runes attached to the throne, it should turn Delilah's painting against her.
My love, word is you've had a change of heart, or your mind is wrong. Perhaps I was too much.
This is a great wrongness. I must be one with the flesh.
Never existed.
My spirit returns.
Enter the canvas, and I will show you my vision.
So this is the world she dreams about.
Thank you.
If I put Delilah on the throne, the painting should trap her in her own fantasy world. You wanted to rule a world of your own, Delilah? So be it.
I've always deserved my justice. Now, what's always been marred and distorted will be perfect. I've waited so long. Sing my songs and lick my flesh. Worship me.
Let's sit down. I'll explain it all.
And so a man born with the face of the Duke took his seat in Karnaca, ruling with empathy for those not born in a palace. The people were surprised by this sudden turn, but did not question their good fortune. In Dunwall, without ever realizing it, Delilah passed into an imagined world where her father's promises were fulfilled, and her subjects would love her forever. As she sailed the ocean with a great fleet and trekked across the Pendician wastes. While in the true capital, Emily the Just, Emily the Clever, ruled for decades over a prosperous, mended empire with Corvo Atano by her side. In his day, Anton Sokolov fired the engines of industry, hurtling the empire into a more sophisticated age. He dallied with nobles, wayward artists, and great inventors alike, drinking in all that life could offer. Leaving Dunwall for the last time, he headed to the cold north, contented at last on a final voyage to take him home. There are things that never change, no matter how hard you try. Questions you must answer. As Megan Foster faded from the world, Billy Lurk stepped from her shadow, setting out to discover her truest self, and seeking the closest thing she'd ever known to family.